Hello guys, this is Ravens from DJ Integrity. Today we are going to see some interesting news in episode 163. The Bangladesh High Court has ordered the government to ban several online applications and games like TikTok, PUBG and Free Fire for next 3 months. Battleground Mobile India iOS version has been released in India. It is available for download on Apple App Store. iPhone and iPad users can download the game right now. Xiaomi is set to unveil its new Mi Notebook series in India on August 26 at its Smarter Living 2022 event. According to the official Amazon page, one of the Mi Notebook model will be coming with a 16:10 display. This display will feature 100% sRGB color gamut. Xiaomi is also teasing that the notebook would be coming with a higher refresh rate display. It is expected to have a resolution of 3020x2000 resolution, which translates up to 6.4 million pixels. The new Mi Notebook would be featuring a backlit keyboard with a fingerprint sensor embedded in a power button. It will also be having a Thunderbolt port for charging and data transfer. Further, it is expected to have a slim profile, which is called as Mi Notebook Slim. Jio phone next price in Indian specifications have been leaked. This phone is set to cost us around ₹3,499. Jio phone next will go on sale in India from September 10. Let's see some of the leaked specifications of this mobile. It comes with a 5.5 inch HD display. It runs on Snapdragon 215 processor. It will be having a 13 megapixel rear camera and a 8 megapixel selfie camera. It runs on Android 11 Go edition and it also has a 2500 mAh battery. Itel has launched the all-rounder smartphone A48, which comes with a reloaded avatar and exclusive benefit from Jio. This offer will be entitled to instant price support of ₹512 and additional benefit worth ₹4000. The Itel A48 carries the credits of being the most affordable smartphone with 2GB of RAM and a water drop notch display. It is priced at ₹6,399 and bundles benefits such as one-time screen replacement offer that lets users avail free one-time screen replacement if the screen is broken within 100 days of purchasing this device. Nothing launched its first product, the Ear One True Wireless Earbuds, in July. The True Wireless Earbuds went on sale for the first time today in India. Minutes after going on sale, the Ear One is out of stock. The Carl Pei, the founder of Nothing, has announced that Ear One was sold out within a couple of minutes after the sale went live. The True Wireless Earbuds was launched in India for ₹5,999. Nothing CEO also revealed that the company had over 4,800 units available for purchase during the first sale. There is no word on the next sale date. Pei, however, stated that the company is working on restocking the True Wireless Earbuds as soon as possible. Motorola H20 and H20 Fusion have been launched in India. Now let's see prices of these two mobiles. Motorola H20 Fusion price in India starts for ₹21,499 for the 6GB RAM and a 128GB version and ₹22,999 for the 8GB RAM and a 128GB model. Motorola H20 cost us ₹29,999 for the single 8GB RAM and a 128GB variant. The Motorola H20 first sale starts from August 24th at 12 PM, while the Motorola H20 Fusion will be available from August 27th at 12 PM Indian Standard Time. This device will be available through Flipkart and retail stores. Vivo X60 5G price in India have been reduced by up to ₹3,000. This phone is now available starting from ₹34,990. The new Vivo X60 5G price in India is effective from yesterday onwards. Redmi 10 Prime is expected to launch along with the Redmi 10 in India. Redmi 10 Prime Indian variant has been spotted on the IMEI database. Redmi 10 launch date in India is yet to be revealed. Samsung Galaxy M52 5G BSM model number SM526B/DS. This handset is speculated to be a rebranded version of Samsung Galaxy F52 5G. Samsung Galaxy F52 5G specifications include a 6.6 inch LCD display, 64 megapixel camera and a 4500 mAh battery. Asus has announced its official e-store for Indian buyers that will offer a range of features and benefits upon the purchase of Asus products online. The e-store is aimed to serve more than 30,000 pin code areas in India. It will also serve as a platform for consumer experience and brand related information in India. The AYR technology will service the Asus e-store. The IQ Z5 is set to succeed the IQ Z3 5G in India. The IQ Z5 Indian variant has been spotted on IMEI certification website with the model number I2018. This device will come with a minor update to the IQ Z3 5G that was launched in June 2021. Earlier this month, Honor had launched its much-awaited Magic 3 series. This lineup was the latest flagship-grade smartphones from the brand, and now company has put up a massive advertisement for the Magic 3 series on the Burj Khalifa to promote the new devices. A patent filed by Apple has revealed that Apple car owners can authorize other users to drive the car without releasing the keys. Indeed, there have been several patents related to the Apple car covering a wide array of concepts and components that have been filed. Obviously, the Apple car will not need any physical keys as it would be operated via an iPhone. So the car will be having a digital keys that would be allowing for key sharing. According to the patent documents, the system will allow someone else to drive your car without the owner divulging critical and the confidential information. Google today finally launches its Pixel 5a with 5G smartphone. This Pixel 5a features a new unibody aluminium design in a new mostly black color option that has a slight green hue on it. This body is an IP67 dust and water resistant. The design, however, is largely identical to the Pixel 4a with 5G. The Pixel 5a has a slightly larger 6.34 inch 2400x1080 resolution OLED display, but it is still having a 60Hz refresh rate. It runs on a Snapdragon 765G processor with a 6GB of LPDDR4X RAM with a 128GB of storage. If we talk about the rear cameras, it comes with a 12MP main camera and a 16MP of ultra wide angle lens, and on the front we will be seeing an 8MP camera. The Pixel 5a has a sizable 4600mAh battery. There's still no wireless charging and the charging is still done with an 18W fast charger. The IQ8 and IQ8 Pro flagship phones has been launched in China. Now let's see about the specifications of these two mobiles. IQ8 has a 6.56 inch flat OLED panel that supports up to full HD plus resolution of 1080x2376 pixels. It will be coming up with a 120Hz refresh rate and an optical in-screen fingerprint scanner. On the other side, the IQ8 Pro has a 6.78 inch Samsung E5 AMOLED screen with a curved edges. The LTPO panel supports 1Hz to 120Hz dynamic refresh rate and the quad HD plus resolution of 1440x3200 pixels. Both models offers a screen to body ratio of around 92%. IQ8 is powered by a Snapdragon 888 processor, whereas IQ8 Pro features a Snapdragon 888 plus chipset. Both the phones offers up to 12GB of LPDDR5 RAM and up to 512GB of storage UFS 3.1. It comes with a pre-installed with Origin OS 1.0 based on Android 11. The IQ8 series features a 16MP selfie camera, whereas it comes with a triple rear camera of 48MP Sony IMX598 primary camera, 13MP of ultra wide angle lens and a 13MP of telephoto snapper. While the Pro model comes with a 50MP of IMX766 main camera, 48MP of Sony IMX598 ultra wide lens and a 16MP of telephoto camera. The IQ8 has a 4350mAh battery that supports for 120W wired fast charging. On the other hand, the Pro model houses a 4500mAh battery that offers 50W wireless charging and a 10W reverse wireless charging. Apart from that, it also supports a 120W wired fast charging. The IQ8 has arrived in two options such as 8GB RAM and a 128GB storage that is costing us around 3799 Chinese Yuan, that is around 43,600 Indian rupees, while 12GB RAM and a 256GB storage is costing us around 4199 Chinese Yuan, that is around 48,150 Indian rupees. It comes in three colors, white, black and orange. While IQ8 Pro model comes in three models, 8GB RAM and a 256GB storage, that is priced as around 4,999 Chinese Yuan, that is around 57,300 Indian rupees. And the second model, 12GB RAM and a 256GB storage, is priced as around 5,549 Chinese Yuan, that is around 63,600 Indian rupees. While as the last model, 12GB RAM and a 512GB storage, that is priced as around 5,999 Chinese Yuan, that is around 68,800 Indian rupees. It comes in white and black color options. Apple last year unveiled the magnetic wireless charging solution called MagSafe. The charging coil is attached to the back of the iPhone with the help of its built-in magnets to charge the device at up to 15W wireless charging. Realme took some inspiration and recently unveiled the MagDart wireless charging for Android devices. The company launched two MagDart devices that charge phones at 15W and 50W speeds. And now Oppo is working on the similar technology. Oppo could soon unveil its MagWalk charging technology according to the certification website. The charging mechanism uses the device magnet to wireless charge a phone with a coil on the back. Oppo has filed a trademark for MagWalk charging. Oppo could also offer a MagWalk with 50 watt and a 15 watt magnetic charging speed. The company could also launch special charging devices that will feature this technology. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.